Welcome to this video, and today video we will discuss about the parvovirideae family. This is the DNA virus, and the causes disease mainly in the canine species and also in the swine. So we will discuss in detail about the parvovirus. The parvovirus word is coming from the Latin word, that is the parvus. The parvovirus word is coming from the Latin word, that is the parvus, and the meaning of the parvus is small. Meaning of the parvus is small, and the diameter of the parvovirus is 18 to 26 in nanometer. The parvovirus is the non-enveloped virus, and they have the icosahedral symmetry. Parvovirus is the non-enveloped virus, and they have the icosahedral symmetry. Next point, possesses a linear genome of the single standard DNA. Parvovirus contain the single standard DNA as a genetic material. Next point, parvovirus replicate only in the nuclei of the dividing host cell. The parvovirus replicate, and the parvovirus replicate in the nucleus of the dividing host cells and form the intranuclear inclusion bodies. And the parvovirus replicate in the nucleus of the dividing host cell, and they form the intranuclear inclusion bodies. They form the intranuclear inclusion bodies. Next point, that is stable in the environment. Normally the parvovirus is stable in the environment, and if the favorable condition is occurs, they causes disease in animals, especially in the canine species. Next point is resistant to heat, solvent, disinfectant, and pH changes. Then the parvovirus replicate only in the nuclei of the dividing host cell. After entering a cell, the parvovirus is uncoated. After entry in the if the infection is occurs and the parvovirus enter in a cell, the first one is the virion is uncoated. Virion is uncoated and is a single stranded DNA, because of the parvovirus contain a single stranded DNA in genome is converted to double stranded DNA by a cellular DNA polymerase in the nucleus. So we suppose that this is the cell. Okay, we suppose this is the cell and this is the cell nucleus, okay, and we suppose this is triangular is parvovirus, if, and this is the coat. This is the coat of the parvovirus, and in coat the presence of the single stranded DNA. In coat present single stranded DNA. Okay. So this is first infect a cell. This is first infect a cell. This parvovirus firstly infect a cell, and after the entering in the cell, the virion is uncoated. First one is the virion is uncoated. These parvovirus is uncoated. First one they enter and uncoated the single stranded DNA. After that they enter in the nucleus and remove or cut, and they have single stranded डीएनए, ओके, दे हैव सिंगल स्ट्रैंडेड डीएनए एंड वी सपोज दैट लाइट ग्रीन कलर दैट इज द सेल डीएनए, ओके, दिस इज सेल डीएनए, ओके. After to that, this single stranded DNA convert in the this single stranded DNA is convert in double stranded DNA by the using of the cellular enzyme that is the polymerase or DNA polymerase enzyme, and the DNA polymerase enzyme is present in this nucleus of the cell. So how to convert a single stranded to double stranded DNA? First one is the virion is a, in fact a cell, and first one is encoded the these virions and remove the coat and present the single stranded DNA. And these single stranded DNA convert the double stranded DNA by the using of the cellular DNA polymerase enzyme in the nucleus. These single stranded DNA convert in the double stranded DNA in nucleus of the cell. Next one point is the following viral replication. After to that, then the classification of the parvoviridae family. The parvoviridae are the two subfamilies. First one is the parvovirinae and second one is the densovirinae. First family is the parvovirinae and second one is the densovirinae. In parvovirinae, which include the viruses of the vertebrates, parvovirinae is the virus that are in fact the vertebrates, and densovirinae viruses they infect the arthropods. Then the detailed classification of the parvoviridae family, parvovirinae and densovirinae. Densovirinae family members are in fact the arthropods. Then the parvovirinae. Parvovirinae include many of the viruses, that is the parvovirus, arthroviruses, amdoviruses, bocavirus, dependovirus. In all of these, the veterinary importance is that the parvovirus and dependovirus. These two viruses are veterinary importance. So first one is the parvovirus. Parvovirus members of this genus are of the major veterinary importance. They are the major veterinary importance. And next one is the dependovirus. Usually depend on the adenovirus for the replication. These dependovirus, they are depend on the adenovirus for the replication in the host cell. Apart from the goose parvovirus and duck parvovirus, clinically unimportant. Okay, some of the importance is also occurs of the dependovirus, but they not causes major disease in wild and domestic animals and also in the birds. Next one is the erythrovirus. Erythrovirus, human parvovirus B19 causes erythroma infection in children. So this is erythrovirus is a human being importance. Amdovirus, Eleutin mink disease virus. Bocavirus, bovine parvovirus and canine minute virus. So this is the classification of the parvoviridae, that is the parvovirinae and densovirinae, two major family, and these family parvoviridae family contain many of the genus that include the parvovirus, erythrovirus, amdovirus, bocavirus and dependovirus. In all of these genus, the parvovirus and the dependovirus are main veterinary important. Next one is the clinical infection. The parvovirus can infect many of the domestic and wild animals. They infect many of the domestic and wild animals, but they cause serious disease in especially in the canine species. Next point, the most important parvoviral disease of the domestic mammals are the feline leukopenia, canine parvovirus infection and porcine parvovirus infection. These are the three main diseases that causes by the parvovirus in domestic animals include the feline pain leukopenia, first important disease that causes by the parvovirus, that is the feline pain leukopenia, canine parvovirus infection and porcine parvovirus infection. These three important disease that causes by the parvovirus infection. Next one is the major classification of the parvovirus and the disease, which disease causes by the which genus and the host of these and some of the consequence of the infection. So first one is the feline pain leukopenia virus. This is the name of the virus. This is the name of the virus, that is the feline pain leukopenia virus. The genus that causes by the genus of this virus, that is the parvovirus, and host is the domestic and wild cats. Feline pain leukopenia mainly the disease of the cats, both of the domestic and wild cats. Consequence of the infection is the highly contagious systemic and enteric disease. The feline pain leukopenia virus mainly the disease causes by the systemic and enteric disease. Most common in the weaned kitten. Common in the weaned kitten. Because of these in the weaned kitten, the immunity is suppressed. So the infection is easily occurs. Manifested by the depression, vomiting, diarrhea, intrauterine infection, abortion, or the cerebral ataxia in the neonatal kittens. If the queen, that is the female of the cat that is pregnant, so intrauterine infection is also occurs and abortion and cerebral ataxia also occurs in the neonatal kittens. Next virus, that is the canine parvovirus. Canine parvovirus second, mainly the canine parvovirus second. The genus of the canine parvovirus, that is the parvovirus, and the host is dogs. The consequence of the infection, highly contagious enteric disease with depression, vomiting, dysentery and immunosuppression. Because of it is the canine parvovirus, they causes enteric disease. Enteric means related to intestine. So they causes the vomiting and dysentery. Due to vomiting and dysentery, immunosuppression also occurs. Because of any of the nutrient not provided in body through or not absorbed through the body, because of the vomiting and dysentery is occurs. Intrauterine or parental infection, myocarditis in the pups, they are also found in the canine parvovirus infection. Next one is the porcine parvovirus. That the genus is, that virus is the parvovirus and host is pig. Consequence of the infection, major cause of the स्टिल बर्थ, म्यूमिफाइड फीटोस, एम्ब्रियोनिक डेथ एंड इनफर्टिलिटी। सो दीज मेन मेजर कॉन्सिक्वेंस इज फाउंड इन द पोर्सिन परवोवायरस इन्फेक्शन। नेक्स्ट वन इज वायरस इज द गोज परवोवायरस, दैट इज जीनस इज द डिपेंडो वायरस, होस्ट इज गीज, कॉन्सिक्वेंस इज हाईली कॉन्टाजियस फिटल डिजीज ऑफ 8 to 30 day old गोसिल डेजी डिजीज, हेपेटाइटिस, मायोसाइटिस इंक्लूडिंग मायोकार्डाइटिस। सो गूज परवोवायरस द कॉजेस मेजर कॉन्सिक्वेंस दैट इज द दिस डिजीज इज द हाईली कॉन्टाजियस, द कॉजेस हाईली कॉन्टाजियस वायरस एंड द कॉजेस फीटल डिजीज ऑफ द 8 to 30 day old गूजलिंग्स, द कॉजेस डेजीज डिजीज। नेक्स्ट वन इज द डक परवो वायरस, दे ऑल्सो कॉजेस बाय द डिपेंडो वायरस एंड द मेजर होस्ट इज द डक। हाई मोर्टिलिटी क्लिनिकल साइन एंड लीजन्स सिमिलर टू गूज परवो वायरस। नेक्स्ट वन इज द और फर्स्ट डिजीज दैट कॉजेस बाय द परवो वायरस इज द फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया। दिस इज द मेनली द डिजीज ऑफ द कैट्स, वाइल्ड एंड डोमेस्टिक कैट। सो फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया आल्सो नोन एज फेलाइन इन्फेक्शियस एंट्राइटिस बिकॉज ऑफ दिस वायरस मेनली इन्फेक्ट और अफेक्ट द इंटेस्टाइन एंड आल्सो कॉल्ड एज द फेलाइन डिस्टेम्पर, ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज फेलाइन डिस्टेम्पर। नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, हाईली कॉन्टाजियस जनरलाइज डिजीज ऑफ द डोमेस्टिक एंड वाइल्ड कैट्स, द कॉजेस बाई द फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया वायरस। फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया डिजीज इज कॉज्ड बाई द फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया वायरस, दिस डिजीज इज वर्ल्ड वाइल्ड। नेक्स्ट वन इज द एपिडीमियोलॉजी, मोस्ट स्पीसीज ऑफ द फेलिडाई आर हाईली ससेप्टेबल टू इन्फेक्शन। मोस्ट स्पीसीज ऑफ द फेलिडाई फैमिली दैट इज द कैट, मेनली इंक्लूड द कैट एंड रिलेटेड एनिमल स्पीसीज, दे आर हाईली ससेप्टेबल टू परवोवायरस और फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया वायरस। दिस इज जनरली एंडेमिक इन अनवैक्सीनेटेड कैट पॉपुलेशन। द फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपीनिया इन्फेक्शन इज जनरली एंडेमिक इन अनवैक्सीनेटेड कैट पॉपुलेशन। All as are susceptible to infection. All as group of the cats are susceptible to infection. All as group cats are susceptible to infection. Disease occurs predominantly in the young. Mainly the disease is predominantly in the young and recently weaned kitten. Young or recently weaned kitten. As a maternally derived antibody levels warning. Okay, so the feline pain leukopenia infection is mainly occurs in the young kitten and recently weaned kittens. Subclinical infection are occurred in the older cats. Subclinicals means they know they cannot show any of the symptom of the disease. Then pathogenesis and pathology. So in pathogenesis, the virus enters through the ingestion or inhalation. The virus enters through the ingestion or inhalation. Replication occurs in the mitotically एक्टिव लिम्फोइड टिश्यू ऑफ द ऑर्थोफैरिंग्स एंड एसोसिएटेड लिम्फ नोड. सो द फेलाइन पेन ल्यूकोपेनिया वायरस एंटर इन द कैट बॉडी थ्रू द इंजेशन और इनहेलेशन एंड आफ्टर टू एंट्री दे आर रेप्लिकेट इन द माइटोटिकली और मल्टीप्लाइंग. माइटोटिकली मीन्स दे आर करंटली मल्टीप्लाइंग माइटोटिकली एक्टिव लिम्फोइड टिश्यू ऑफ द ऑर्थोफैरिंक्स एंड एसोसिएटेड लिम्फ नोड्स. देन नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, वायरेमिया डेवलप्स विथिन 24 आवर्स आफ्टर द एंट्रिंग ऑफ द वायरस इन एनिमल बॉडी. दे डेवलप्ड वायरेमिया विथिन 24 आवर्स. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, रिजल्टिंग इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द सेल ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइनल क्रिप्ट्स एंड द लिम्फोपोएटिक सेल्स ऑफ द बोन मैरो थायमस लिम्फ नोड एंड स्प्लीन. आफ्टर दैट द वायरेमिया डेवलपमेंट द इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइनल क्रिप्ट्स सेल्स and then the lymphopoietic cell of the bone marrow, thymus, lymph node and spleen. Infection early in the gestation usually lead to abortion and reabsorption if the cat or queen is in early pregnancy. They are usually lead to abortion and reabsorption of the fetus or fetal material. Next one is the viral invasion later in the gestation may result in cerebral hypoplasia, retinal dysplasia or early neonatal death. If the queen are in later pregnancy or in third trimester, they causes the cerebral hypoplasia, retinal dysplasia or in early neonatal death. After to that, the clinical signs. The incubation period of the feline pain leukopenia is 2 to 10 days. The incubation period of the feline pain leukopenia virus is the 2 to 10 days. Next point, subclinical infection. They have many of subtype of the infection and many type of the infection, that is the subclinical, perclinical, acute, chronic, to that like. So subclinical infection. In subclinical infection, the common and result in a mild fever and leukopenia, usually followed by the lifelong immunity. In subclinical infection, the subclinical infection is common in the cats and they causes mild fever and leukopenia also, and they produced lifelong immunity. Then subacute disease. The subacute infection or subacute disease causes depression, fever. They causes depression. Subacute infection causes depression, fever, and diarrhea, lasting to 1 to 3 days, followed by the rapid recovery. After 1 to 3 days, the recovery is occurs. And first symptom is the depression, fever and diarrhea. Next point, most severing in young unvaccinated kittens between 6 to 24 week of the age. Feline pain leukopenia virus most severe in young kittens, and those kittens these are non-vaccinated, and age group is most commonly seen in the 6 to 24 week of age. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, करेक्टराइज्ड बाय द सडन ऑनसेट ऑफ द प्रोनाउंस्ड डिप्रेशन, एनोरेक्सिया एंड फीवर. मीन क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स, इन क्लिनिकल सिम्टम्स एंड साइन भी इंक्लूड द डिप्रेशन, मेनली द डिप्रेशन, फीवर, एनोरेक्सिया और आल्सो इन सम टाइम द डायरिया. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज द ड्यू टू वॉमिटिंग, डायरिया और डिसेंट्री कैन रिजल्ट इन द सीवियर डिहाइड्रेशन एंड इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इम्बेलेंस इज ऑकर्स ड्यू टू वॉमिटिंग, डायरिया और डिसेंट्री. द कॉजेस द डिहाइड्रेशन इन एनिमल बॉडी एंड आल्सो द डिहाइड्रेशन, द इलेक्ट्रोलाइट इम्बेलेंस इज ऑल्सो ऑकर्स. The mortality rate ranges from the 25% to 90%. High mortality rate is occurs with the feline pain leukopenia virus, that is 25% to 90%, with most death occurring within 3 to 5 days of the onset of the illness, and most of the death occurs in the young young kittens and unvaccinated kitten or wean kitten. Suddenly wean kitten, most of that high death rate occurs in young animals that are weaned or unvaccinated. Next point, animals which survive require the several week for full recovery. If the animals are survive with the feline pain leukopenia virus, they require the several week for the recovery. Next point is the subnormal temperature are followed by the death within 24 hours. Subnormal, if the animal infected with the feline pain leukopenia, so the subnormal temperature, if the animal have subnormal temperature, so the death occurs within 24 hours. Next point, infected pregnant queen usually show no sign of the illness, but they show the abortion, mummification of the fetus, and if the they are in the late pregnancy, so another symptoms just like undeveloped or partially developed fetus. Next one is the diagnosis. Feline pain leukopenia should be considered when unvaccinated cat present with diarrhea. If feline pain leukopenia is considered in which animal they are diarrhea, and these animal are non-vaccinated but they have diarrhea, so they consider that is the infection with the feline pain leukopenia virus. Next point, specimen for the virus isolation in the primary feline cell line include oropharyngeal swab, feces, spleen, mesenteric lymph node and ileum. So these things that are taken for the virus isolation, that are the oropharyngeal swab, feces, spleen, mesenteric lymph nodes and ileum. Next point, last number of the virus particle may be demonstrated by the electron microscopy in the fecal sample from the cat with acute disease. If the cat with the acute disease, so we can take the fecal sample and identify and demonstrate the large number of the virus particle. Next diagnostic method, that is the typical histopathological changes may be present in section of the ileum and jejunum. So if we histopathological identification, want to histopathological identification, so find the histopathological changes present in the section of the ileum and jejunum. Histopathological changes present in the section of the ileum and jejunum. These are the intestine part. Intranuclear inclusion body may be detected in crypt cell of the intestine. Next point, viral antigen can be detected in the feces using latex agglutination, ELISA, hemagglutination and employing pig or rhesus monkey red cells. So if we want to detect the viral particle in feces, so we can use the latex agglutination test, ELISA or hemagglutination, employing pig or rhesus monkey red cells. So these are the serological tests we can also use in the confirmatory diagnosis of the feline pain leukopenia virus in cats. Then control, how to control the feline pain leukopenia virus in cat. So immunity following natural infection is stronger and long lasting. If the natural infection occurs in the cats, they provide the or they find the strong and long lasting immunity than the vaccinated. Next point, vaccination is the principal control measure. Vaccination is the principal control measure in cat population against the feline pain leukopenia virus. Next point, modified live and inactivated vaccine are commercially available against the feline pain leukopenia virus. Two type of the vaccine is available, that is the modified live or inactivated vaccines. Okay, two type of the vaccine is available against the feline pain leukopenia virus is modified live and inactivated vaccines. So this is all over about the feline pain leukopenia virus. Next disease, that is the canine parvovirus infection. Canine parvovirus infection, and canine parvovirus infection most commonly occurs in the dogs. Most commonly occurs in the dog species. So first point is infection with the canine parvovirus is in short they called as CPV, canine parvovirus, in dog with the high morbidity and mortality. Why this canine parvovirus infection is important? Because of it is high morbidity rate and high mortality rate. High morbidity means if we have 10 dog and the infection is occurs, so near about 6 to 8 dog are infected with the canine parvovirus, and in 6 to 8 5 to 6 dogs are die. So they called as the high morbidity and mortality rate. Next point, three subtypes of the virus are currently recognized. Three subtypes of the canine parvovirus infection, that is canine parvovirus 2A, canine parvovirus 2B, canine parvovirus 2C. These are the three subtypes recognized of the canine parvovirus, that is the CP2A, CPV2B or CPV2C. Next point, that is the infection and vaccination with one subtype generally confers immunity against the other subtypes. Infection or vaccination of the one type, they also provide immunity against other subtypes. Just like the infection occurs with CpV2a. So these CpV2a subtype provide immunity also against the CpV2b and CpV2c also. Next one is the epidemiology. Many canine species are susceptible, just like the dogs, cat and other canine species are susceptible with this virus. Transmission is predominantly by the fecal oral route. Infected dogs shed large number of the virus in their feces. Infected dog shed the large number of the virus in their feces. Pathogenesis and pathology. The virus replicate initially in the pharyngeal lymphoid tissue and Peyer's patches. The virus mainly the replicate after the entry in animal body. They replicate in the pharyngeal lymphoid tissue and Peyer's patches. Next point. Once viremia developed, the main target tissue are those with rapidly multiplying cell population. If the viremia is developed in animal, the main target tissue is those they are rapidly multiplying cell population in animal body. Next point, first 2 weeks of life, there is the active division of the cardiac myocytes, allowing the viral replication with result necrosis and myocarditis is occurs. Next point, hemorrhages into the intestinal lumen in severely affected pups. Clinical signs. Incubation period of 4 to 7 days. Animal with enteric disease show sudden onset of the vomiting and anorexia. If the enteric form is developed, so sudden onset of the vomiting and diarrhea show. Next point, diarrhea often blood stain developed within 48 hours. Normally the starting symptom is the vomiting and anorexia, and after 48 hours that the diarrhea is also occurs, and they are if blood stained. Next point, feces have the foetid smell. Diarrhea or feces, they have the foetid smell. This is also a characteristic symptoms with the infection of this. Prolonged illness is uncommon, and severely affected animal die within 3 days. Animals which survive the disease developed a long lasting immunity. If animal are survive with this infection, so they developed a long lasting immunity. In the myocardial form, the form of the disease, which is now rare because of rarely the virus infect the young animals, young one pups. Affected pups usually show the sign of the acute heart failure before 8 week of the age group. Then the diagnosis. Sample for the laboratory examination should include the feces, blood and other tissue, particularly affected portion of the intestine and myocardium. Mainly for the laboratory examination, we take the fish, include the feces, blood and other tissue, especially the lymphoid tissue or rapidly multiplying tissue, and also the some affected portion of the intestine and myocardium in young ones. Immunocytochemical staining can confirm the presence of the viral antigen in tissue section. Next point, the presence of the basophilic intranuclear inclusion body in the cardiac myocyte is confirmatory. The presence of the basophilic intranuclear inclusion body in the cardiac myocyte is confirmatory in the young pups. Next point, polymerase chain reaction. We can also use the PCR or polymerase chain reaction for the confirmatory diagnosis. Serological test including the hemagglutination inhibition VN, ELISA and indirect immunofluorescence may confirm the diagnosis. So these serological tests we can also use for the confirmatory diagnosis. Next disease, that is the porcine parvovirus infection. Porcine parvovirus infection is the worldwide infection. This is the worldwide infection and single serotype of the porcine parvovirus is present. Cause of the reproductive failure in pigs. Main cause, that is the reproductive failure in the pigs, that causes by the porcine parvovirus infection. Clinical signs include infected pigs shed virus in their feces and other secretion. The affected pig, they show the they shed the virus in their feces and other secretion also include in the if they are male pig, they secrete the virus in their semen also. Porcine parvovirus infection is a major cause of the SEMA-D. An acronym used to describe the porcine reproductive failure in which stillbirth, mummified fetus, early embryonic death and infertility occurs, that called the SEMA-D. So porcine parvovirus infection mainly cause the SEMA-D. This is important term. Mainly cause the SEMA-D that include the stillbirth, M4 mummified fetus, E4 early embryonic death and I4 infertility, that called as the SEMA-D. Next that is the abortion and the neonatal deaths have been reported occasionally. Abortion and neonatal death also occasionally reported in the porcine parvovirus infection in pigs. Then the diagnosis. When reproductive failure is detected in the young or recently introduced show, particularly if associated with the mummified fetus, infection with porcine parvovirus must be considered. If the reproductive failure is detected in young pigs or young show or also in the recently added in herd, so they are particularly associated with the mummified fetus or infection with the porcine parvovirus, infection must be considered. Next point, that is the demonstration of the viral antigen in the cryostate section of the fertile tissue by the immunofluorescence particularly in the lung tissue is reliable and sensitive. For the demonstration of the viral antigen in cryostate section of the fetal tissue by the immunofluorescence test, that is the immunological test, particularly that occur with the lung tissue is the reliable and sensitive to the porcine parvovirus identification. And next one is the PCR assay. वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज द पोलीमरेज चैन रिएक्शन दैट फॉर द कन्फर्मेटरी डायग्नोसिस ऑफ द पोर्सिन परवोवायरस इन्फेक्शन.